When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me.
This is a Rap Chat original. Pre-K, LL. elementary, junior high, high school, college, and you gon' fly. Walking down the street with your mask and gown, everybody's looking at you clapping loud. Like I stood on stage, pretended in my room, had to watch the whole commencement on Zoom. Virtual high fives won't give me the bug, never mind COVID, just give me a hug. Today is my day, I really deserve it, this degree is mine. Even after you burn it, I'm another level higher, but far from finished. I told my last grade, you are diminished.
Are diminished. There's a ticket to your destination. Nobody can take it. You graduated, you made it. There's a reward for your dedication. You're ready to face it. Congratulations, you made it.
Throw your cap in the air. Throw your cap in the air. Throw it like you just don't care. Throw your cap in the air. Throw your cap in the air. Show your cap in the air.
Bachelor's, master's, or PhD. Thank you, mama and D.A.D. But first, glory to God, he's in control. He done kicked it off like the Super Bowl. Then I did the rest, had to keep it on track. I done studied so hard, you could see my crack. Now that that's all over, gotta get me a job. But I'll be self-made, I ain't working for Bob. Nor Craig, Hank, not even for Sally. Benjamins and Grants, that's what I would tally. I'm a career man now, not forgetting my friends. We about to be lit with social distancing ends. A party over here, a party over there. I pray Corona will disappear. We all made it this far. I'm part of the many, the graduating class of 2020.
Here's a ticket to your destination. Nobody can take it. You graduated, you made it. Here's a reward for your dedication. You ready to face it. Congratulations, you made it.
Throw your cap in the air. Throw your cap in the air. Throw it like you just don't care. Throw your cap in the air. Throw your cap in the air. Show your cap in the air.
Hey! parents, guardians, families, friends, and graduates, joining us from both near and far and kitchens. Welcome to the celebration of the class of 2020's graduation at the Brooklyn Science and Engineering Academy. Although this celebration is not what any of us expected or wanted for our students and graduates, this is not how we ever imagined saying goodbye to you. We hope that you know the love and admiration we hold for you, and that we will continue to support you as you move beyond middle school. Throughout your time at BC, you formed friendships and relationships that have helped define who you are as young people and as scholars. Your actions and your resolve have also defined you. We recognize you, the class of 2020, for the legacy you've left and the lessons you've learned along the way. Not every lesson comes easily. Some have been more difficult and more intellectually and emotionally challenging. We've pushed and tested you along the way. Note that you've pushed and tested us along the way as well. We send you off to high school with the confidence that your time with us at BC has made an indelible impact upon your lives. We have worked with you to develop not only your academic skills in ELA, math, science, and social studies, but also support your growth as artists, as designers, as critical thinkers, as communicators, as junior ambassadors, as users of technology, and as members of a greater community. Despite the trials that you've faced, you've risen above them, persisted, and worked to overcome the difficulties that have gotten in the way of achieving your goals. You have embraced drastic change and have remained engaged and focused, and in doing so, you have shown respect for yourselves, your families, and your school community. Now we hope that you are prepared to take the next step. Despite not knowing exactly what our future may hold or how it will look, we do know that we are standing at a precipice of change. We know that for the past few months, you have taught us greatly about our world, about what connects us and what divides us, about how we lift one another up and stand by what we know to be right and just. We know that there is still a lot to stand up for and against, and that there isn't any one solution to the problems that we face. And that is what the mission of our school is. After all, it is to prepare our students for a world that does not yet exist. You have taught us that this also includes preparing our students for the world that they will help to create. So class of 2020, as you take this one small step among the many ahead, we challenge you to choose to stay engaged and stand up for what is right, to persist and to raise your voice to make a change in the world. Graduates, please join me in thanking those people in your lives who have supported you on your academic journey thus far. Your parents, your guardians, your friends, your family members, and your teachers. We also thank you, graduates, for your work, your dedication, and for giving us you to help us build our school community at the Brooklyn Science and Engineering Academy. Congratulations.
Hello, students. I'm Richard Carranza, Chancellor of New York City Public Schools, the best school system in the country. I have a special message for all of you, our graduating eighth graders. I am so proud of you. This is a big moment in your life as you get ready to go to high school. You're going to discover new interests, meet new friends, tackle more and challenging academics, and learn so much more about yourself and the world around you. And I know you are ready. You didn't just make it through middle school. You finished it out learning from home while the world around us changed. And I know that wasn't easy. Now you know that no matter what obstacles come in your way, you can overcome them. So as you get ready for high school, I have a few words of advice. Find your passion and be clear about your values. Use your voices for positive change and amplify the voices of friends and classmates who are not always heard. Keep reading and learning this summer, and keep safe as you have fun. You are the young leaders we need right now, and we will be waiting for you in September. Congratulations.
I am Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams. And on behalf of the Borough of Brooklyn, I want to congratulate you, the graduating class of 2020. This is probably not the graduation you were expecting. Every generation has its own unique challenges across the globe, but it's the lessons learned from overcoming them that brings us closer together and help us thrive. From Pearl Harbor and World War II to 9/11 and now COVID-19, each and every generation can rise with resiliency in the face of tragedy. We are capable of acting as one and moving forward together, not just as classmates and peers, but as human beings. If there's anything that COVID-19 is teaching us, it is that we can face any challenge if we stand strong and work together to meet it head on. Class of 2020, this is your unique challenge. The end of any chapter in your life will rarely look the way you first envisioned it, but that's okay. It is our ability to adapt that creates the foundation of our future. You have reached a wonderful milestone that required endurance and resilience, and those same abilities will help you to adapt to the globe around you. This will not be the last time you have to adapt to circumstances beyond your control, but you are now more ready than ever to face whatever else life throws at you. This is your time, this is your moment. Congratulations, class of 2020. We look forward to seeing your continued determination, creativity, and inspiration as you change the globe for the better.
Hello, everyone. I know you may not feel like it, but you are indeed the chosen class for such a time as this, the class of 2020. You're also a united class, the pandemic class that has the entire world striving to graduate with you. Of course, this is not the graduation ceremony you envisioned. You've been dreaming about that walk across the stage, your family and friends cheering you on, whoop, whoop, the caps flung joyously in the air. But even though there may not be pomp because of our circumstances, never has a graduating class been called to step into the future with more purpose, vision, passion, and energy, and hope.
Allow me to offer just a few pieces of advice. That's obligatory. Bear with me. My first piece of advice is this. Don't just get involved. Fight for your seat at the table. Better yet, fight for a seat at the head of the table.
I'm convinced that the only thing that kept me going was that I loved what I did. You've got to find what you love. And that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life. And the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking and don't settle.
My advice to you is to take time to follow your passions. You never know where they'll lead you. It's far more fulfilling to do what you love than to do what may be expected. And if you can find a career that you're passionate about, like I did, there's no telling how far you'll go.
I think a lot of people dream. And while they are busy dreaming, the really happy people, the really successful people, the really interesting, engaged, powerful people are busy doing.
Hey, class of 2020, you're on your way to high school. Do your best, be your best, and enjoy every moment of the experience.
I see your life as already artful, waiting, just waiting and ready for you to make it art.
Graduates, my advice to you is to get to know your teachers and let them know who you are. Let them know if you're struggling with anything, need support, and most importantly, let them know what you think. You're your best advocate, and I can't wait to hear about all your successes and endeavors in the future. Congratulations.
And at the end of the day, by staying true to the me I've always known, I found that this journey has been incredibly freeing. Because no matter what happened, I had the peace of mind of knowing that all of the chatter, the name calling, the doubting, all of it was just noise. It did not define me. It didn't change who I was. And most importantly, it couldn't hold me back. I have learned that as long as I hold fast to my beliefs and values and follow my own moral compass, then the only expectations I need to live up to are my own.
Congratulations to all of our BC graduates. Some of the words that I've lived by are making sure that we set goals and always working to meet those goals. Even if we stumble and fall along the way, keep on going. You'll get there. Good luck, guys.
You have to go through life with more than just passion for change. You need a strategy. I'll repeat that. I want you to have passion. You have to have a strategy. Not just awareness, but action. Not just hashtags, but votes.
And so as you graduate, as you deal with your excitement and your doubts today, I urge you to try and create the world you want to live in. Minister to the world in a way that can change it. Minister radically in a real, active, practical, get your hands dirty way.
I want you to look back on the journey that brought you here. What moments challenged you most? When were you asked to step outside of your familiar territory in order to rise to the occasion of your potential? How have you pushed past your fear? I want you to remember those moments because they will embolden you and affirm you and remind you that you did this. You completed this journey. You answered the call. And now you can continue to do so, but the choice is yours. When you leave here today and commence the next stage of your life, you can follow someone else's script. Try to make choices that will make other people happy. Avoid discomfort, do what is expected, and copy the status quo. Or you can look at all that you have accomplished today and use it as fuel to venture forth and write your own story. If you do, amazing things will take shape.
What will your essential service be? What really matters to you? The fact that you're alive means you've been given a reprieve to think deeply about that question. How will you use what matters in service to yourself, your community, and the world? For me, it's always been talking and sharing stories. For you, well, that's for you to discover. And my hope is that you will harness your education, your creativity, and your valor, your voice, your vote, reflecting on all that you've witnessed and hungered for, all that you know to be true, and use it to create more equity, more justice, and more joy in the world. To be the class that commenced a new way forward, the class of 2020. Bravo. Brava, brava, brava.
Hello, and congratulations to the class of 2020. The Salutatorian Award recognizes a student with the second highest cumulative average in a graduating class over the course of their 3 years at the Brooklyn Science and Engineering Academy. In order to achieve this great accomplishment, students must possess a sense of drive and motivation. They must be willing to work hard, they must put in great time and effort, and they must be willing to take risks, fail, and learn from mistakes. The student we recognize as this year's Salutatorian possesses all of these qualities and has maintained her high academic standing in middle school with panache and confidence. It is my honor and pleasure to introduce the Salutatorian for the class of 2020, Ms. Hope McGirt. Congratulations, Hope.
Hi, class of 2020. Many of you guys know me, and for those who don't, my name is Hope, and I am your Salutatorian. Today, we're here to celebrate us. After 3 long years of hard work, regardless if it was 2 years or 1 year, we made it. We finally graduated, so you should really give yourself a round of applause. I'll wait. Okay, I just assume you did. I appreciate everybody that's here today for this ceremony. Everybody knows that we're going through a lot. There's a lot of events going on in this world right now, but we still work hard and we push through. Even through this stressful time, we all knew what we wanted, and that was to graduate. So we should really congratulate ourselves. We deserve it. We all grew as a family and made some friends and memories that we will cherish forever. We all encountered challenges and problems, especially with each other, but in the end, we learned how to work through them. I honestly think that we left a mark on this school. Like, I'm pretty sure many teachers will remember us and miss us for all the bad moments and the good ones too. I would like to thank some of my friends for all the times they made me laugh, had my back, and picked me up when times got rough. For all the funny moments at Town Hall where we all shared a good laugh, watched people leave the auditorium, you know who you are, and listened to Mr. Campbell motivate us by telling us we can do better. I'll certainly remember all the times we had at lunch, which included roast battles, dance-offs, and all the times we rushed to go outside and the drama. Anyways, a few things that I could say BC did was the teachers always encouraged us to do things to the best of our ability. And before you go and disagree with me, they all did it in different ways and forms. I'm pretty sure we could all leave saying that there was at least one teacher or para that motivated us and believed in us. I could also say that the teachers and paras really took a handful of nonsense from us. That's why I would like to thank Ms. Mapp and Ms. Oliveri for making us feel comfortable enough to barge into your office at literally any time so you can listen to both serious and foolish problems. I'd like to thank all the teachers of the school for taking nonsense from us. One thing that I could say BC did was provide some opportunities. This included being a United Nations Junior Ambassador, attending BEAM, allowing us to compete in a series of competitions, Regents classes, SHSAT prep, and more. This really helped us learn new things about ourselves, and I would also like to thank the students for making class time funnier and more enjoyable. I would like to thank my friends for being one of the reasons why I wanted to come to school, but will always be on top is getting an education. I want to thank Mr. Aradowitz and Mr. Pasilico for being fun and chill social studies teachers. I want to thank Ms. G and Ms. Swirl for making math class fun and interactive. I want to thank Mr. Lembo for encouraging me to work through problems in algebra regions. And I want to thank Ms. Jennings for all the opportunities she provided for being my peers and constantly believing in us. I want to thank Ms. Magero for always teaching us something new in science and for being a calm teacher. I want to thank you for teaching me that certain things I think I wouldn't need now, I may need in the future. And I want to thank you for teaching me to always take advantage of every opportunity that comes your way. I want to thank Mr. Novins and Mr. Eisenberg for supporting us when we didn't do the right thing. I want to thank Ms. Solomon for her patience with us during circles, especially since 804 had you in the morning. I want to thank Ms. Candace for being a blunt person. I want to thank Mr. Ross for being a fun ELA teacher. I want to thank Ms. Gordon for being a realistic crew teacher. She always allowed us to discuss real-life problems in crew and make crew feel like a safe haven. Since it was always females in the crew, you taught us as African-American females we should love each other and not fight with each other. I want to thank Mr. Myers for being with us through these past 3 years. I also want to thank the substitute teachers that many of us will never forget. This includes Ms. L, Ms. Nelson, Mr. Moore, Ms. Ellis, and many more. You truly had an impact on us all. I want to thank all the teachers that interacted with us in the school year. I want to thank Mr. Campbell for dealing with our problems, managing a lot in the school, and for wanting the best for your first graduating class. Lastly, I want to thank all the teachers and Ms. D for leading such a project-based school. I want to thank Ms. D for getting to connect with the students, considering our ideas, and making them a reality. I want to thank you for being a thoughtful principal and caring about our feelings. We could come to you and talk to you about anything, and you know how to be serious and fun, and we all appreciate you for it. Also, we would like to thank you for feeding us whenever we had a showcase. I want to thank my Bob for believing in me and my friends for always expecting me to do great on something. I want to thank all the students at BC for being who they are. I want to thank the student government for all they did in the school year, especially for bringing Rod Tootle to perform at the school. I want to thank everyone for the inside jokes and the things we did throughout the school year. I'm grateful for all the problems I encountered because it told me to be careful who you have around you and to learn from your mistakes and make changes. I want to thank my friends and peers who helped me get through remote learning. This school really helped me steer towards what I want to be when I grow up. They helped me turn the negative into positive. Personally, I know I like to argue and debate, so I want to thank my classmates for disagreeing with me because this helped me to learn how to verbally defend my thoughts and opinions with proper reasoning and evidence. This also falls into how I was always able to get feedback from my classmates, peers, and teachers. This taught me how to learn from my mistakes and to do better next time for any subject, whether it was math, ELA, social studies, or science, I think both students could agree. BC taught us a lot of things. We were taught to work towards our goals, the power of words, the power of friendships. We were taught to plan for our future, work hard, and never take no for an answer. We were taught how to deal with situations we encountered. We were taught to learn how to be ourselves, and I know we all somewhat found ourselves during these years. We made friends and learned lessons. We are now moving on to high school, and this is a scary step. We are now separating and going our own ways. We are going our own paths, and we have reached a big step in our lives. We are now moving forward. I believe that we all can be what we aspire to be in our lives. Staying positive and keeping a positive mindset is key because life is only as good as your mindset. I want us all to take time to fully know yourselves and love yourselves. Remember to be patient and persistent and to work hard because in life, in order to get, you have to give. Keep your possibilities open and do not just have one plan. I know it may seem too early to plan, but the earlier the better. Remember that it is okay to fail. Make friends and do what you're afraid to do. Never think that you know everything because when we adopt this mindset, we open our hearts to learn more. Lastly, I want you all to remember these two words, wait and hope. I will miss you all, and again, congratulations to BC's class of 2020, and I hope you enjoy the rest of our ceremony.
Sion Abrams, graduating with honors. Dasani Alexander Julian. Nathaniel Alexander. Christopher Alfred. Aaron Ashton, graduating with honors. Isaiah Barrett, graduating with high honors. Makai Barrett. Crystal Barry. Emalachi Bubron. Jovici Belnau. Isaiah Bovell, graduating with honors.
Eric Braxton, graduating with honors. Sarah Brown, graduating with honors. Fiona Bruno, graduating with honors. Christopher Bryan. Jeremy Carter, graduating with honors. Oliver Castell, graduating with honors. Zario Celestine. Abraham Charles, graduating with honors. Javon Cleofat, graduating with high honors. Ajani Cole, graduating with high honors. Lamar Coombs Dixon.
Samuel Cordova, graduating with honors. Joshua Crooks. Destiny Husset. Kyla Cumberbatch, graduating with honors. Tavion Cush. Madison Daly, graduating with honors. Gemma Disogus, graduating with high honors. Michaela Desrosiers. Akila Devanish, graduating with honors. Andrew Dixon. Janelle Dowden. Isaac Dyer.
Jordan Ellis. Ivanka Etienne, graduating with honors. David Fiev, graduating with high honors. Harmani Flood, graduating with honors. Tishana Fortis, graduating with honors. Jaleel Foster, graduating with honors. Dejanay Francique, graduating with high honors. Stevens Frederick, graduating with high honors. Dylan Gabriel, graduating with honors. Christian Gonzalez, graduating with honors. Jason Gonzalez. Jaden Goss.
Madison Green. Graduating with honors, Brian Grenade. Justin Harris. Elijah Higgins. Anthony Hunter. Graduating with honors, Javion James. Graduating with honors, Nicholas James. Zorian Jones. Graduating with high honors, Deja Josephs. Graduating with honors, Marlon King. Graduating with honors, Azul Knight.
Elijah Kair. Joelle LaRose, graduating with honors. Nyla Ladstetter. Skylar Lapomorel, graduating with honors. Berlin Leandre. Sharif Lee, graduating with honors. Adam Lindor, graduating with high honors. Xavier Lasso. Aaron Marksman, graduating with honors. Amari Marriott. Hope McGirt, graduating with high honors.
Maxim McPherson. Wilma Minaya, graduating with honors. Shane Modest. Jamar Morrison. Madison Nelson, graduating with high honors. Shermaya Paul, graduating with highest honors. Leasia Payne. Kolisha Palou. Jafia Peters. Joshua Phipps, graduating with honors. Princeton Pierre.
Taina Pierre, graduating with honors. Kamar Pitters, graduating with honors. Darius Prime. Joelle Reese, graduating with high honors. Kamani Regis. Jelani Rigobert. Angelina Roberts, graduating with high honors. Giovanni Robinson, graduating with honors. Anthony Roman, graduating with high honors. Akai Roper Lewis. Jadon Rose. Ashley Roseway, graduating with high honors.
Tiffany Samaru, graduating with honors. Isaiah Samuels, graduating with high honors. Justin Schenkel, graduating with honors. Paige Simpson. Tiffany Sukai, graduating with high honors. Michael Soa. Michelle Soa. Naeem St. McCary. Joshua Tavares, graduating with honors. Lamelia Taylor, graduating with high honors. Ariel Telfair.
Elijah Thompson. Marisol Triumphel. Leah Trotman. Cesar Vargas, graduating with honors. McKaylee Vasquez. Marco Velasquez Garcia. Nathaniel Weeks Pereira, graduating with honors. Kyle Williams, graduating with high honors. Riley Jasper Wright. Taylor Young.
Laramie Zamore.
Give the Principal's Award of Excellence. This award recognizes students who have demonstrated overall academic achievement in all learning tasks and for those demonstrating academic excellence and prep values. This award goes to Shermaya Paul and Sharif Lee. Both students have demonstrated BC's prep values and have pursued their academic achievement for all 3 years. It is an honor to give the two of you the Principal's Award for Academic Excellence. Congratulations.
The Assistant Principal's Award of Excellence is given to two students who have demonstrated excellence in both academics and character. It is my honor to give this award to Tiffany Sukai and Jeremy Carter. Congratulations.
I'd like to present the Dean's Award for Leadership. This award is given to students that exhibit a great ability to lead others and set the example for classmates to follow. This year's recipients are Kamar Pitters and Isaiah Barrett. Congratulations, gentlemen.
The next award goes to the student who demonstrated the most obstacles and has overachieved them. I'd like to present this award to Jason Gonzalez. Congratulations, you've gotten the Counselor's Award.
Hi, it is my honor to present the Guidance Integrity Award to Justin Schenkel. Justin, you exemplify the do the right thing when no one is watching. You have enriched the lives of the peers and the staff here at BC. You are always willing to help. You are respectable and you are kind. I wish you many, many success in the future. So go be great.
The BC Prep Value Award recognizes students who have consistently exhibited our prep values of prepared, respectful, engaged, and persistent. This year's winners are Ivanka Etienne, Stevens Frederick, and Tashona Fordyce. Congratulations.
Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams I Am Brooklyn Award is an award that recognizes students who have made vast improvements through the course of their academic years at BC. This award goes to Isaac Dyer. Congratulations, Isaac. Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams Excellence Award is an award that recognizes students who have demonstrated overall academic excellence. This award goes to Lamelia Taylor. Congrats. This award is the Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams One Brooklyn Award. This award represents a student who has gone above and beyond to assist their community and peers, encourages civic pride, and enhances the lives of all Brooklynites. This award goes to Hope McGirt. Congratulations, Hope. Nick Perry's Graduate Award for Academic Achievement goes to a student who excels academically. This student is not only excellent from an academic perspective, but she is a fantastic young lady who I've grown to know and I'm so excited for. Angelina Roberts, congratulations. Nick Perry's Graduate Award for Academic Improvement goes to a student who may not be excelling academically, but has made a personal best effort to achieve and continuously shows academic improvement. This award goes to Skylar Lapamar. CSA's Award for Leadership is presented to a student who has made an outstanding contribution to his or her school and the community. This young man assists in every BC event that we have and is wonderful. Congratulations, Dylan Gabriel. CSA's Award for Leadership goes to the true leaders, the parent leaders. This award is presented to a parent or parents who have made an outstanding contribution to the children and BC community. This award goes to Joshua Crooks's mom, Sherri-Ann Crooks, Dylan Gabriel's mom, Anne Marie Ford, and Jaleel Foster's mom, Stephanie Foster. Thank you for everything that you do.
The Council of School Administrators Blantz Schwartz Award recognizes a student who has overcome academic challenges and has demonstrated high motivation and determination to succeed. It is my honor to bestow this award to Adam Lindor. Congratulations, Adam.
All right, I'm excited to announce the recipients of the BC Art Award. There are three recipients this year. In order to earn the BC Art Award, a graduating member of the 2020 class has to demonstrate exceptional ability within the visual arts and a strong commitment to improving artistic practices. The three recipients are Sarah Brown, Tiffany Samaru, and Jeremy Carter. Congratulations, guys. You've just grown so much over the last 3 years, 2 years, and it's been awesome to see. You're off to great things. Okay, I'm excited to announce the UFT Visual Art Award recipients for this year's graduating class. In order to earn the UFT Art Award, students need to demonstrate an extensive knowledge and understanding of the concepts in art. And while there are many students who have shown this over the years, three have stood out, and those three students are Ajani Cole, Shermaya Paul, and Skylar Lapamarl. Congratulations, guys.
Hello and good day to all. I am proud to be presenting the English Language Arts Department Award. This award recognizes students who demonstrated extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in English language arts. And this award goes to Tiffany Sukai and Ajani Cole. I am proud of you guys. Keep up the good work. Hello and good day to everyone. I am happy to be presenting the UFT Language Arts Merit Award. This award recognizes students who demonstrated extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in English language arts. And this year's recipient is Stevens Frederick, a powerful mind. Congratulations, Stevens.
This award recognizes students who have demonstrated excellence in English as a new language. I present this award to Joshua Taveras. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020. This year, the 2020 Math Department Award goes to two students who have best exemplified their inner mathematicians using analytical skills to solve real-world problems. This year's recipients of the Math Award are Stevens Frederick and Angelina Roberts. Congratulations, you guys. I'm proud of you. You did a great job all year. You're going to be great mathematicians going forward. This year's UFT Math Merit Award recognizes two students who demonstrated extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in mathematics. This year's award goes to Joshua Taveras and Isaiah Samuels. Congratulations, gentlemen.
This year's Physical Education Award from BC goes to Javon Cleofat. I'm impressed by the way he was dedicated to being successful in the gym and throughout his time here at BC. Good luck in high school, bud. This year's Physical Education Award of BC goes to Jelani Regabert. His commitment to success over the years has been impressive, and I wish you all the best of luck in high school. Congratulations, bud.
Congratulations, seniors. You all made it. I am proud to announce the recipients for this year's Science Departmental Award. This award recognizes students who demonstrated extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in science. This award goes to two students, Tiffany Sakai and Shamaya Paul. Congratulations!
The UFT Certificate for Science goes to Adam Lindor. This award recognizes students who demonstrated extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in science. Adam, you are persistent, you are a go-getter, and this was very difficult for me to choose just one student for this award, but you've earned it. Your amazing tenacity, your curiosity, your showing up and getting the work done earned you this award, especially also your constant discovery and inquiry about science. Congratulations.
Congratulate Madison Nelson and Sharif Lee for the Social Studies Department Award for 3 years of hard work and achievement in their social studies classes. I want to congratulate Ashley Roseway for the UFT Social Studies Merit Award. Great job in your social studies work, thinking about how history has affected us today and how we can plan for a better future. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ms. Gordon. Hello, graduates. Congratulations to everyone, all the graduates, BC Class of 2020. I am here to present the Special Education Departmental Award. This award is presented to a student for outstanding achievement in special education. And the award is presented to Skylar Lapimel.
The UFT Music Teachers Award recognizes students who demonstrate extensive knowledge and understanding of concepts in music. This year's award goes to Isaiah Barrett and Wilmer Manaya. Congrats, class of 2020.
Hello to everyone. I am proud to be presenting the UFT Achievement in Computer Technology Award. This award recognizes students who demonstrate extensive knowledge in understanding technology. And this year's recipient is Crystal Barry. Congratulations.
The UFT Award for Achievement in Character goes to Ajani Cole. Ajani, you have continuously displayed great character, fairness, respectfulness. You're just a wonderful citizen. You're a wonderful student. You're trustworthy. You're all around kind to your peers and kind to the staff. Go forth. Conquer the world. Continue to be the best you can be. Congratulations to you.
UFT Outstanding Community Service goes to Mr. Isaiah Samuels. Congratulations, Isaiah. We are so proud of you.
I'm so happy to present the UFT Environmental Awareness Award to Hope McGirt. Hope has done a phenomenal job at providing support, awareness, and even advocacy for the environment. From her involvement in the BC Recycling Rewards Program, or even using her voice for change at different junior ambassador speaking engagements, her hard work has not gone unnoticed. And Hope, I'm so proud of you. Keep up the amazing work fighting for our environment.
The Association of Foreign Language Teachers Award is for 3 years of hard work and helping others. And the award goes to Jovici Belno. Congratulations, Jovici.
Hi, Junior Ambassadors. I'm so proud of you and all the hard work you've accomplished in changing our world for the better. I am so happy to announce the Junior Ambassador Awards for this year's graduating class. Christopher Alfred. Crystal Barry. Malachi Buburn. Michaela Desrose. Deasia Josephs. Hope McGirt. Shemiah Paul. And lastly, Kamar Pitters. Congratulations and good luck in high school.
This award recognizes students who participated and was recognized in the Reboot the Earth Challenge under the auspice of the United Nations to improve upon or build a new software program that addresses the current climate crisis. The following students developed, designed, and participated in a two-day hackathon program. Looking at the UN videos, you'll notice they were the youngest participants in this program. They were the only students from middle school. The following outstanding award is given to Gemma Desauguste, Deasia Joseph, Wilmer Manaya, Tiffany Sukai, Marco Velasquez, Dylan Gabriel, Hope McGirt, Shemiah Paul, Crystal Barry, and Dijane Francique. Congratulations! This award recognizes students who participated in the International Day of Women and Girls in Science. This was a food waste challenge competition. Our students presented a winning solution to reducing food waste. Congratulations to the following students: Tiana Pierre, Michaela Desrosiers, Janelle Dowden, Shemiah Paul, Crystal Barry, Marco Velasquez, Dylan Gabriel, Nina Ladsetter, Angelina Roberts, Tiffany Sukai, Hope McGirt, Soraya Brown, Erin Marksman, Akila Devonish, Keila Cumberbath, Lamelia Taylor, and Angelina Roberts. Congratulations, ladies. You won this competition. We are so proud of you. The winners of the Congressional App Challenge representing New York's 9th Congressional District are Shemiah Paul and Crystal Barry. Congratulations, ladies. You have made BC history. You are the first students ever to compete and win this award.
Hello everyone, it's me again, Ms. Gordon. I'm here to present the Distance Learning Award. This award is presented to students, recognizes students who have been diligent, hardworking, persistent, and punctual during remote learning. Those students are Eric Braxton, Samuel Cordova, Ajani Cole, Isaiah Bowell, Isaac Dyer, and Akai Roper Lewis. Congratulations, guys.
During our challenges with remote learning, some students still remain committed. I am proud to announce the recipients for the Remote Learning Award. This award recognizes students who have been persistent, diligent, hardworking, and punctual throughout the entire time. This award goes to Gemma Desauguste, Deasia Josephs, Dejanae Francique, Maxim McPherson, and Stephen Frederick. Congratulations and keep up the good work.
With great honor and distinction that I present the award for valedictorian to Shemiah Paul. Shemiah has achieved an overall grade point average of 96.7% over the course of the past 3 years. She is a New York City junior ambassador with an amazing future ahead. Congratulations, Shemiah.
Wow, we actually did it. We're graduating. Never would I have thought we'd be doing it in this way, but it's still happening. But guess what? We still have to do this 2 more times before we're completely done. so get used to it. Let's go back a few years. Sixth grade, September 2017. We were all very new, some confused, maybe even lost. We went through a year exploring our strengths and weaknesses, making new friends, and experiencing new things. Seventh grade, September 2018. We got a little bit more comfortable, a little more daring, and open to taking risks. Eighth grade, September 2019. We were fully immersed in BC waters, taking full control of the boat we'd boarded only 2 years prior. We were okay, comfortable. Then 2020 came, and at full speed. So many things happened, you probably couldn't count them all on your 10 fingers. I won't go into further details about the specific events because 2020 isn't finished printing out yet. There could be more events waiting in the wings of the 2020 theater. However, most eighth graders only go at the end of the year was to graduate. In order to do that, we had to persevere through all of the tough times that we had and are still going through. But look at us. Despite all that, we are still graduating. You still met your goal. I remember all the funny moments we had throughout the years, like in eighth grade, when Ms. Sorrell held that Christmas party before the break. 804 remembers that day. When junior ambassadors went to multiple competitions, both in real life and virtually, and dominated every playing field. Like in 704, when Ms. Gito held Kahoot games for us, and we'd have little alliances at our tables if we realized we weren't going to win playing alone. You guys remember that. But wait, what about the experiences not everybody got to see, like the summer program? We know the inside jokes, like Moo Moo, and the very weird, and I mean weird, things that happened. All the little pranks we pulled. And we went to Dunkin' Donuts almost every day that the workers started our orders before we even opened the door. Plus, all the showcase days we had. After, Ms. D would promise us pizza or sandwiches for our hard work. She would always keep those promises. I had the privilege to be in 04 class all the way through middle school. 604, 704, and 804. Weird, right? Only certain people remember this, our high school regents classes, Living Environment, US History, and Algebra. Even though these classes at times were hard, I'm especially talking about you, Algebra, they were fun and we would learn these new things yet still enjoy ourselves. I personally had the most fun in Algebra, yet it was the hardest topic for me. There were some obstacles. Wait, let me rephrase that. There are a lot of obstacles. Nope, still not right. Let's try that again. There was a mass amount, an abundance, a whole population of the world's worth of obstacles throughout our middle school life. We weren't that focused, and we were aiming lower than our eighth grade counterparts in other schools. Despite what we were told about our testing percentages, which we were reminded of almost every single day, we never gave up. Our teachers never gave up. Even though they seemed as if they were very close to, they told us that we could do it and the hard work would pay off someday. They wanted us to see change, to see us be successful. I want to thank the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade teams that taught the class of 2020. And we're determined to get each and every one of us through middle school in one piece. Thank you. As a whole, sure, we were very horrible at times. But when you sifted through individually, you could see the real potential of every student. Keeping my speech short and sweeter than honey, I close with this. Despite all the challenges you face in life, never give up. The moment you give up is the moment you let someone else win. Kobe Bryant. And remember, Black Lives Matter, and wash your hands. Thank you.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. I am so proud of you all. You are proof that nothing will stop you from reaching your goals. I will truly miss you all. Have a great summer.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You are making history with your graduation. and I can't wait to hear about your achievements and endeavors in the future. Congratulations!
Hello, 2020 graduates. It's Ms. Tattergray and Ms. T. As you know, I just wanted to say congratulations to all of you guys who are part of the class of 2020. I especially wanted to say congratulations to the students who were in the ENL program this year. So that's Maricel Trainfell, Joshua Taveras, Javichi Belno, Oliver Castell, and Wilmer Manaya. I'm so proud of you guys, and I can't wait to see what new things will behold as you enter into high school. So I wish you the best, and we will miss you at BC. So best of luck to you, and continue to keep on going. I'm so proud of you guys.
Congratulations, 8th grade. You guys did it. Congrats on this huge and momentous accomplishment. You guys had to push through a really unfortunate circumstance, but you guys made it through. You guys made it to the finish line. I wish you all the success in high school.
Hi, 8th graders. First of all, I want to say congratulations on you guys for graduating and making sure you guys completed your courses. I'm super proud of you guys. And I just wanted to say I had a pleasure teaching you guys. For those of you who took Algebra 1 with me, we had so many great times. And I just want you guys to continue your ambition, drive, motivation, keep going, keep loving math. And if you're not going to remember not one thing from me, you better remember that quadratic formula. I'll see you guys soon.
Hello, class of 2020. I am going to miss you guys so much, but I wanted to give a special shout out to Shemaya Paul, our valedictorian, go, and Hope McGirt, our salutatorian. Congratulations, ladies. You guys are amazing, but you already know that, and so do your parents. Class of 2020, expecting wonderful things from you. Thank you so much for allowing us to teach you. I am honored to have been your science teacher.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You guys have achieved a tremendous accomplishment, graduating middle school under the most unique circumstances. We're never going to forget this graduating class. Keep up your great work. Good luck in high school, and I'll miss you guys.
Hello, class of 2020. I just want to share my congratulations with you. I've been really lucky to be an art teacher over the last 2 years. For some of you, it's been actually all three of your years at BC. It's been really, really cool to watch you guys grow as artists, but also as just students and people. Seeing some of you as sixth graders growing up to being these mature eighth graders. You've grown as artists. You're improving your skills all the time, but more importantly, you're learning how to share your ideas and your own messages through your artwork. And it's just been so wonderful to see you guys do that. I'm going to miss you. It's really, you know, really always sad to say goodbye because we're doing this remote graduation. Every graduation, I always tear up a little bit, but you guys don't have to see that because we're doing it remote. But I am very sad to see you guys graduate, but I'm also very excited because I know you're off to awesome experiences into high school and beyond, and keep making art. You guys are awesome. I'm going to miss you.
Hi, BC, class of 2020. You made it. You worked hard and you persevered. I can't wait to hear of all the great things that you're going to accomplish in high school and beyond. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2020. First off, let me say that I'm extremely proud of you guys. A very, 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 very long time ago, I was sitting where you are sitting right now. And Adam, does it go? Okay, I'll just leave it here. And I really didn't understand how significant that accomplishment was. I'm proud of you, and I hope that you see that we started off the year, you were learning history. We ended the year with you living history. And as you graduate and go off into the world, into high school, college, and beyond, I hope that you will use what you learned at BC and you will make history. Basically, you need to understand that if you don't like the world that you're living in, you need to change it. And you guys definitely have the power to do that. Congratulations.
Say goodbye to you in person, but I am grateful for the time that we had together. I hope you've learned as much from me as I have from you. I hope you go off to high school and beyond and do amazing things, which I know you're prepared for. I can't wait to hear all about your journeys and what comes next. Congratulations.
And you got 1 minute until we day. Uh-huh. 1 minute until we day. Uh-huh. If you came here to change your community, change your bubble, change your school, change your block, we want to see the we day symbol up high. These three fingers right here. These three fingers right here.
Turn it.
Yo.
Uh-oh, let's give the instructions. Okay. You guys, follow what we do. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Teachers too.
Teachers too. Okay. Let's go.
Everybody get down low. Everybody get down low.
Everybody please get down low. So, on the count of three, you're gonna go crazy. Yeah. You're gonna jump and make as much noise as possible. Come on, jump. Let's go. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, jump. Without the dedication and generosity of our next guest. Please welcome to the stage the co-chairs of We Day On, Ornella Barra, Carolyn Anderson, and Alan Jones!
problem. 9 out of 10 people surveyed had no idea about the impact of food waste on climate change, and 8 out of 10 people were shocked to hear that in the US and UK, nearly 45 million people went hungry every day. Beginning with our city's middle school students.
I'm Hope McGirt.
I'm Akila Devanish.
I'm Michaela Desjazer.
I'm Crystal Berry.
I'm Shermaya Paul.
I'm Tiffany Sukai.
I'm Janelle Dowden.
And I'm Marco Velasquez.
We're from Brooklyn Science and Engineering Academy.
Nothing beats ideas from people on the ground, especially when, you know, little kids, they have less restrictions on what ideas are possible.
Hi, hello.
Hi.
Nice to see you guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I love that you're all representing your schools with the t-shirts and everything. How excited are you that you won?
Very excited.
What's your favorite lunch item at school?
My favorite lunch item at school is the peach barbecue chicken.
Mine is the chicken tenders.
Mine is the chicken with waffles.
Mine's have to be the mozzarella sticks.
Mine is the garlic bread.
Mine is the chicken nuggets.
Mine is the cookies.
Was it intimidating looking at the data and doing data analysis?
Well, at first we were surprised by the amount of data that we had collected because we had help from our other peers. So it was really surprising.
So it was a lot of information to...
Yeah, it was like about 3,000 foods being wasted.
You mean 3,000 items of food?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. Tell me more about the solution.
The solution was to basically change the options that we were getting for lunch because many students weren't eating the lunch because of peer pressure and people would say it's nasty. And if we changed the menu and we actually provided like good foods, that whole mindset would change.
Talk to me more about this peer pressure.
Like in New York and our school, they call the food free free. So then they'd be like, oh, you're eating the free free and all of that. And like they would like if you're eating the lunch food, especially if it don't taste good, but like sometimes we have a long day of school and we could be stressed out and we could be really hungry. But then like because like people around us are like kind of judging us about it, we're gonna throw it away knowing that we really wanted to eat it.
And a lot of the people have opinions and they're our friends, so like what they say influences what we do, basically.
The solution is to change the menu based on what people want to eat.
Yeah. So we were thinking that like we could survey our classmates and tell we could think of new options so that everybody could actually like the food and that peer pressure would like decrease a lot.
How has this project helped you think about your food practices at home?
Sometimes I would throw away the food I don't want. So at least at home I would be grateful about the food that my mom would give me. And I think about the life choices that I've made, so yeah.
And also, my mom, like, she would make a whole bunch of food so we could eat for the week. But then I would spend my money on, like, things like junk food. And I'm now realizing that I would be wasting the other food we have at home because it eventually gets thrown away.
Mm-hmm. So, less junk food. That's good, right? All around. How about you guys? Did this change the way that you think of food waste at home?
Yeah, I think it changed the way because usually I wouldn't eat food. I'm not that much of an eater, but it made me think about people who are actually hungry and want food and don't have the opportunity to eat.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes my mom cooks food for like different days. So like when I come home, she would expect me to eat the food, but like then I eat the food in school. So that's sort of like food getting wasted.
How would you look at food consumption at home and would you do anything differently now?
Yeah, because sometimes I would ask my mom to, you know, serve me and put food on my plate, and sometimes she puts more than I actually want, and I waste a lot of it, and it really showed me that I should actually put a little less.
Mm-hmm. That's a really good point, honestly.
We chose to dedicate this workshop in support of the International Day of Women and Girls in Science.
I just love the event today, just from the moment when the girls were arriving, just seeing them stream in with their awesome teachers and chaperones, knowing that they'd put in work already, collecting the data, really looking at the issue, using these tools of data and tech at their schools, and then coming up with incredible ideas. And we really saw that today.
Hi, my name is Crystal.
And I'm Shamaya.
We are from Brooklyn Science Engineering Academy, and we're junior ambassadors. We would like to show you our app.
So this is our app, and it's called Tech Care. This is the menu screen, and you navigate using the arrows. This is the sign up screen. So first you're gonna scan.
The United Nations brings together the global community around pressing challenges. Here in New York City, we're doing our part. Now let's check out our New York City Junior Ambassadors and their local leadership on global issues.
Climate change is important to me because future generations will be impacted by our decisions and how we treat the environment.
Zero hunger is important to me because it means that people aren't starving in the world and have equal access to food.
To fight climate change, we're recycling the bottles and building the models.
Replanting these seeds to suit our needs
to help the earth be rebirthed.
Affordable and clean energy is important to me because not only does it affect my family in Nigeria, it affects my classmates in the Bronx.
As junior ambassadors, we are committed to quality education by sharing our experiences,
participating in fundraisers.
Water is important to our economy.
Water is important to our health.
Water is important to all generations.
Water sustains us.
New York City is preparing for the future by facing down the challenge of inequality and confronting our climate crisis. By investing in our infrastructure, we're securing a livable future for the next generation.
Quality education is important because it allows students to prosper in a variety of subjects and topics.
To ensure quality education, we need dedicated teachers with the correct amount of learning supplies for all students.
Without quality education, we would not be able to improve and change the world.
Life underwater is important because there are many animals becoming endangered species as we know it. And now we must come together as a whole to fix it.
We are committing to saving the oceans by reducing our reliance on single-use plastics.
At the New York City Department of Health and Mental Hygiene, we believe that good health is a right, not a luxury. All New Yorkers, regardless of race, immigration status, or zip code, must have an equal opportunity to live healthy lives and have access to quality health care for their physical and mental well-being.
I'm taking action to eliminate poverty by reducing inequalities that our diverse communities face to improve our world.
Estoy tomando medidas para eliminar la pobreza y reducir las desigualdades que comunidades diversas enfrentan para mejorar nuestro mundo.
Life on land is important to me because it is a way each of us can do our part to protect our natural resources.
We're tackling climate crisis to bring hope to our communities by advocating for green infrastructure and renewable energy.
Immigration is important to us because
we should all be treated fairly.
Everyone should be able to migrate.
I am a child of immigrants,
and it's overlooked.
The New York City Commission on Human Rights empowers New Yorkers to build vibrant and diverse communities free from discrimination and harassment.
The Department of Consumer and Worker Protection is a central resource for New York City workers, whether you are employed in domestic work, in the fast food or retail industries, or as a freelancer, we've got your back.
Gender equality is important to me because I believe every man and woman deserves a fair chance to be successful at life.
New York City is leading the way as a sustainable city. New York City agencies collaborate every day to ensure that we are creating a better future for all New Yorkers, from universal pre-K to IDNYC and the Green New Deal.
The Mayor's Office of Sustainability is working for the 8.6 million New Yorkers who want a future where we consume less and no longer make products that we can't unmake.
We are committing to affordable and clean energy by designing and distributing media about solar and wind power right here in Queens and sending solar kits to 6 continents.
We are the Mayor's Office for International Affairs, and we partner with the United Nations and cities and states around the world around the Sustainable Development Goals. We are New York City, and we are for the goals.